I thank Dr. Thoman for having me here. So we are going to talk about tele-ophthalmology to reach the unreached. You all know telemedicine is when screening can be done in a peripheral place and the images are beamed to the telemedicine hub, where a specialist can view the images and take decisions, management decisions, and referral decisions, and refer the patient to the nearby where specialized care is available. Ophthalmology is eminently suitable for telemedicine because most of our conditions are elective in management. There are very few emergencies, and most of the conditions have a long window period for intervention, like diabetic retinopathy or glaucoma. And even if you look at it, ROP also gives you at least a few days time by which time a decision can be taken and the child can be shifted for treatment. And it's the telemedicine to a large extent solves the difficulty due to lack of trained personnel in peripheral areas. If you look at Kerala, like we said earlier, it has the highest literacy in the country. It has the best health statistics in the country. And yet, specialized eye care is available only in and around 6 major towns in the whole state. So we go on to telemedicine in Kerala. Amrita Institute pioneered the telemedicine project in 2002 with technical support from the Indian Space Research Organization, and it had telecardiology, teleradiology, teledermatology, telepathology, psychiatry, telementoring, mobile telemedicine unit, and an e-learning network along with teleophthalmology. And this is our network that is connected to more than 60 centers from Leh, Ladakh to Lakshadweep, and 9 international centers. We are one of the 5 centers in India to be linked to 53 centers in the African subcontinent through the Indian Pan-African project. And we have some village resource centers in Kerala and Tamil Nadu also linked to the network. So we routinely conduct eye cams in Wayanad, Idukki, and also in some neighboring states. Lakshadweep and, like I said, Leh, Ladakh, and few northern states are also connected. I will go into the project details later in a small video, which will keep you entertained. In the meantime, this was in the private sector, and it took around 10 years later, in 2011, when telemedicine came to the government sector in Kerala. The Regional Institute of Ophthalmology, Trivandrum, launched its Sunayanam teleophthalmology program in 2011 with technical support from the Center for Development of Advanced Computing. And it was the first e-health application in India that used the WiMAX connectivity that we are all familiar with of BSNL, with a minimum 512 kbps. And this is the mobile telemedicine unit of Regional Institute of Ophthalmology, Trivandrum. And District Hospital Palakkad launched a Nayana Patham in 2013, which is also a mobile telemedicine unit, teleophthalmology unit. And they have screened more than 300 CAMs in rural areas with more than 10,000 people. This is not specific for a disease. You can screen for glaucoma and diabetic retinopathy and any other eye ailment along with that. And the CEDAC won the Manthan Award in the Asia-Pacific section for the e-health category for the technical support that they gave to these two projects. And the latest entrant is Government Medical College Kottayam, which is launching next week. So in conclusion, teleophthalmology is an excellent method to bring specialized eye care to rural masses, and Kerala is one state which has put this into practice. And with more and more centers joining in, we can truly become a world-class healthcare state in the next decade. We will go on to the video.
Our story begins in a remote village in Wayanad called Meppadi.
This was a very remote place in Kerala called Wayanad. It's a hill station.
Let us meet this villager, Rajan Pillai, and listen to what he has to say.
This man, like many others in Kerala, has proliferative diabetic retinopathy.
He has no facilities for evaluation and treatment here in Wayanad.
He has no money to travel far to avail the treatment elsewhere. Will Rajan Pillai's eyes be lost the way these eyes have been lost to diabetic retinopathy?
Amrita Institute of Medical Sciences presents Amrita Kiranam,
a ray of hope.
This was our team which pioneered the project in 2002.
Proliferative diabetic retinopathy is a time bomb that ticks in the eye till it bleeds.
WHO projects that 75 people go blind every day from diabetic retinopathy.
The burden of this disease far outweighs the reach and extent of currently available eye care services.
To overcome this shortage, Amrita Institute of Medical Sciences and Indian Space Research Organization, in collaboration with Direct Relief International, launched its Tele-Ophthalmology program in 2006.
It focuses on delivery of a comprehensive screening, evaluation, and management program at the grassroots level.
Let us see the components of this Tele-Ophthalmology project. The mobile telemedicine unit is a multipurpose vehicle. The interiors and equipment of which vary according to the speciality it caters to. For tele-ophthalmology, it is equipped with a Zeiss VisuCam Light fundus camera and Zeiss Visula slit lamp delivery system. The AIIMS telemedicine hub provides technical and logistic support for the outreach programs. Now let us return to Mepadi, where a mobile telemedicine unit has set up a diabetic retinopathy evaluation and management camp. Rajan Pillai has found his way to this camp and is being examined in detail. Fundus photography and fluorescein angiography are done in the mobile telemedicine unit. The COMSAT transmits these images via satellite to the AIIMS telemedicine hub. A qualified vitreoretinal surgeon views the images and management decision is taken. Once the decision to laser is taken, laser delivery is carried out on site in the mobile telemedicine unit. The real-time transmission of images to the central AIIMS hub enables the senior retinal surgeon to give technical directions and guide the procedure. Ladakh and Kargil, the northern frontiers of our country, being remote and inaccessible, the availability of advanced healthcare facilities is limited. Tele-ophthalmology has transformed eye care in these regions through tele-consultations. The doctors here can use telemedicine facilities to get expert advice from Amrita Institute to solve diagnostic dilemmas and manage complicated cases. They say they benefited immensely from these tele-consultations.
Something which is required for Kargil, it's a boon for the patients and doctors' legislation.
The AIIMS Tele-Ophthalmology project has won widespread appreciation.
The National Geographic reports
Benefits of telemedicine, delivering help from hundreds, even thousands of kilometres away, are already well established. But how to deliver that same kind of system to even the most remote areas, especially say times of a natural disaster. That's the challenge. And this one possible solution.
Meanwhile, back in May party, Rajan Pillai goes about his daily activities, a contented man. The job done here, the van moves on, to carry expert eye care services to others, very much in need of it.
So that's in short for teleophthalmology. Thank you for your patient hearing. I'd be happy to take any questions.